Let's talk about everybody's favorite subject, equipment. We're going to talk about where it came from. And this could be your single biggest fixed expense when you're looking at opening a gym if you buy new. And with the exception of Amy, you guys didn't do that. Ben, tell me where your equipment came from.
We had been previously running a business, so we have been piecing it together kind of throughout time, but we primarily did a lot of our stuff through Craigslist. We go on Craigslist, and all of our rowers came from Craigslist, all used, all actually from the same guy. There's the local guy that just remanufactures or refurbishes rowers. But I would buy a pair of dumbbells at a time. I would drive around and pick up a pair of dumbbells, pick up another pair, and pick up another pair. I also went to auctions, and auctions were where I got the majority of my equipment. Auctions are an amazing thing. They're on the internet. There are these businesses that are going, these fitness clubs that are going out of business, and you go to these and buy unbelievable amounts of equipment for pennies. I bought my first 15 or 20 barbells for $100 total. It's insane what goes on. I bought 6 treadmills. These are commercial grade treadmills that retail for $4,500 a piece. I bought 6 of them for about $800. The auction thing was just a complete find. It was by luck. It's one of my members is big into auctions, so she kind of turned me on to them.
It's kind of neat. We put the Globo Gyms out of business, and then we buy their stuff really cheaply. Jay, how did you come about your equipment?
Similar to Ben, I was always looking through Craigslist, trying to find the best deals that I can, much like him, piece by piece. If I saw a set of dumbbells, if I saw a rower, I had a few Model B Concept 2 rowers, so that was kind of, no one used to like use them. Everybody wanted the Model Cs if they had the opportunity. And we'd fabricate a lot. A couple of our guys were welders, and there were definitely times where the pull-up bars were sketchy, and if you kipped too hard, you'd start to see them kind of yank out of the wall. That's fine, just push it back in. And the one thing I would say about that is if you are buying used equipment, just be smart about it, because at some point it's worth it to buy newer equipment if the older equipment's going to break and fall apart and be unsafe for use.
Let's talk about that quality criteria. And Ben, you laid out in your questionnaire quite a few pieces of criteria when purchasing equipment. Two things. How do I make sure that the equipment I'm buying is going to stand up to CrossFitters? And then what pieces of equipment do I actually need to buy? You know, we all know that there are some things in the CrossFit gym that are more necessary than others.
Yeah, for sure. I think that first and foremost as CrossFitters, we need barbells and we need bumper plates. We're going to be doing Olympic lifting. I think that's an absolute necessity. After that, I think the next thing you get is a pull-up rig, whether it be manufactured or purchased. When I go about making purchases and kind of prioritizing what I think is needed, I think about first and foremost, how often is it going to be used in the class setting and how many different uses can it have? Thirdly is how much floor space is going to take up. So while buying GHDs is great, if you have 12 GHDs and you're a small facility, you're not going to have any floor space to train your clients. So I think that floor space is actually the most valuable thing we have as a CrossFit gym. Most CrossFit gyms have a huge amount of training space, but I've been in a lot of gyms that kind of clutter them up with these huge freestanding racks or even punching bags hanging down in the middle of the room, and that takes away from the ability to train your clients. So I think that, you know, the versatility of the equipment, how much space it takes up, obviously the quality of it, and thirdly in that, when I purchase a piece of equipment, I like to not just buy one. Because the chances are, if you're buying one, you're not gonna be able to use it in a class setting. If you have a class of 10 people and you have one, you know, 53-pound kettlebell, you can't run a class with that 53-pound kettlebell. You need to buy multiples. So if we can't get enough piece of equipment to run the class with it, we don't purchase it.
And is that the principal advantage that you see in not going the Craigslist route now that you're a successful affiliate, now that you're generating cash, is going to an equipment provider and being able to purchase those instead of trying to find them one at a time?
I think that going off the Craigslist route has a number of benefits. Now, the first is the time consumption. Like, I just don't have the time to go driving around town all day. When I was training 2 classes a day and I had, you know, 30 members, That's what I did. I had the time to do it. Now, my time is so much, I don't have the time to be doing that. So first is time saving of just going to a one-stop shop. The next is that you're sure that you get, you know, you can duplicate your equipment, the same thing, multiples, you know, all, you know, you get shipping breakdowns and discounts for the more you buy and stuff. But I even think, like, I think kind of like Amy would say is, you know, having your gym be presentable and having, like, I think it looks really cool to have, you know, at this point, to have 10 Model D rowers as opposed to, like, these, you know, bunched together type things. You know, one has a kind of a cool feel, but, you know, if you're able to have that professional look, is a pretty cool thing to be able to do.
And when we think about, you know, the action bias as we illustrated it, listen, if you really want to do this, you can start this in mom's garage with one pair of dumbbells you found off Craigslist and a pull-up bar you made together out of plumbing pipe. And if your alternative is nothing, do that. You know, Amy, when you talked about equipment, obviously you've gone a different route. You guys had a good cash pile to start your business with, and you came to us and we kind of put that package together. You said buying used equipment, in my mind, isn't worth it. Why?
Well, it's just, you know, and it's less uniform for one. I mean, you have one nice barbell and a, like 10 crappy barbells, then, you know, everyone's gonna be fighting over the nice barbell. So it's good to, like, just have uniform equipment. It's just, you know, just more appealing in general. And it was just a lot less hassle. And I mean, people, like, again, with the money, like, you want to be fair. People are paying money to come here, so they should be using the best equipment that's really out there. And, you know, it makes us, you know, stand out a little bit more just because we have nice barbells, nice bumper plates. Everything's kind of, you know, brand new.